Welcome students. In this session we are going to discuss about monitoring of gaseous pollutants. In this session the contents I am going to cover are monitoring of SOx, monitoring of NOx, monitoring of carbon monoxide, it means CO. First coming to monitoring of SOx. SOx is nothing but oxides of sulfur. So the method which we are going to use for the monitoring of oxides of sulfur in atmosphere is modified Western gate method. This is the method using our National Pollution Control Board also using the same method. In this method, sulfur dioxide in air is absorbed in a solution of potassium tetrachloromercurate or sodium tetrachloromercurate. That solution is also known as TCM. Then dichlorosulfide mercurate complex is formed. So this is the chemical reaction involving here. This is the chemical form of TCM. After that, the complex is made to react with the para-rosaline and formaldehyde to form the intensely colored para-rosaline methyl sulfonic acid as an end product. And the absorbance of the solution is measured by means of a suitable spectrophotometer. The concentration of sulfur dioxide is directly proportional to the concentration of P-rosaline methyl sulfonic acid. So in this process, the end product is the para-rosaline methyl sulfonic acid. This is the end product of the chemical reaction. So after the formation of the end product, para-rosaline methyl sulfonic acid, we need to take a sample of the solution, and then we have to keep the solution in spectrophotometer. Spectrophotometer is a device which is used to check the presence of oxides of sulfur in the air sample by the absorption method. Here the absorption of UV radiation is directly proportional to the concentration of sulfur present in the sample tube. By using this instrument we can find out the concentration of oxides of sulfur present in the sample whose end product is para-rosaline methyl sulfonic acid. Next topic is monitoring of oxides of nitrogen. The stack monitoring of oxides of nitrogen is accomplished by Jacobs-Hoxer method. The contaminated air contained nitrogen dioxide is bubbled through a solution of sodium hydroxide. This results in the conversion of nitrogen dioxide into sodium nitrite and sodium nitrite. So this is the chemical reaction happening here. The product is then passed to a mixture of hydrogen peroxide, sulfonylic acid, hydrochloric acid, and naphthyl ethylene diamine dichloride. So the sodium nitrite so formed is then diazotized with sulfonic acid, and the diazonium salt couples with the naphthyl ethylene diamine dichloride. The concentration of nitrogen dioxide can be determined by Lambert-Beer's law by determining the concentration of coupled compound using spectrophotometer. See here, in this process, first of all, we will bubble air sample, it means which contains oxides of nitrogen, it means pollutant air. A pollutant air makes pollutant air first of all reacts with sodium hydroxide, and then it forms sodium nitrite and NaNO3. It means sodium nitrate and sodium nitrate it will form. After that, the formed product like sodium nitrate and sodium nitrate is then passed to a mixture of hydrogen peroxide sulfonic acid, hydrochloric acid, and naphthyl ethylene diamine dihydrochloride. Once the solutions, it means the products, have been passed through this, the sodium nitrate diazotizes with sulfonic acid, and then it will form diazonium salt couples with naphthyl ethylene diamine dihydrochloride. It means it will produce a salts of naphthyl ethylene diamine dihydrochloride. So then the concentration of nitrogen dioxide can be determined by Lambert-Beetz law. So Lambert-Beetz law, what is Lambert-Beetz law? Lambert-Beetz law is used to calculate the concentration of absorbate in the absorbent. So by using that law, we can calculate the absorbed nitrogen dioxide, which is absorbed by the naphthyl ethylene diamine dihydrochloride solution. So in this reaction, it means here absorbate, what is absorbate? The substance which is getting absorbed by liquid is called as absorbate. It means gases act as absorbates, and the substance which is absorbing gases is called as absorbent. It means liquids are absorbents here. So in this reaction, the salts of naphthyl ethylene diamine hydrochloride solutions act as absorbent, and the nitrogen dioxide act as absorbate. So nitrogen dioxide get absorbed by the solution, and then the absorbed concentration of nitrogen dioxide can be calculated by using this law, and then the concentration of coupled compound also can be calculated by using spectrophotometer. Next one is the monitoring of carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide in flue gas is analyzed by non-dispersive infrared spectroscopy. So this is the NDIR diagram. So the NDIR consists of four parts. First one is the infrared lamp in this diagram you can see here. Next one is the gas chamber in which we will hold the, or we will keep the sample. And next one is the filter. Next one is the infrared detector. In this process, the infrared lamp produces the infrared rays, and the carbon monoxide have the capability to absorb the infrared rays. So here you have to remember that carbon monoxide, it means CO, have the capability, or it have a habit of, have a capability, or you may call it as a habit, have a habit of absorbing infrared rays with infrared rate of specific wavelength. So in gas chamber we will keep the pollutant gas. So the pollutant gas contains carbon monoxide, and whenever the infrared lamp produces the infrared rays, the carbon monoxide present in the gas chamber will absorb the infrared rays. Then at here you can see that a filter is there. The filter which filters the wavelength, various wavelengths of the infrared rays. And next one is the detector. In detector, we can, it means we can detect that what is the, what are the different types of wavelengths of infrared rays entered into the detector or passed over the filter. So in this process, simply we can say that the carbon monoxide can absorb this some quantity or some few wavelengths of infrared rays within the gas chamber. So the wavelength which is remained, it means which is not absorbed by the carbon monoxide, can be entered into the detector through filter. Understand or no? So, and the absorbed quantity of infrared radiation in the gas chamber will give the concentration of carbon monoxide present in the gas sample. Simple, that is the principle here. See here, the infrared lamp gives out a beam of infrared light which can be measured by the infrared detector placed at the opposite end of the gas chamber. When a gas sample is allowed to pass into the gas chamber, the carbon monoxide gas in gas chamber absorbs a specific wavelength of infrared rays. It means the carbon monoxide only can absorb the infrared rays whose wavelength is in between 900 nanometers to 10,000 nanometers. The wavelength filter located just before the infrared detector allows only that the wavelength of light that has not been absorbed by the carbon monoxide gas, which is then detected by the infrared detector. A sensor is used to calculate the concentration of carbon monoxide gas in the gas chamber in terms of parts per million or milligram per liter. Thank you. In this session, we have discussed about monitoring of various gaseous pollutants. It means these are the three major gaseous pollutants: oxides of sulfur, oxides of nitrogen, and carbon monoxide. So in previous session, we have discussed that monitoring is nothing but measuring the concentration of pollutants within a sample. So in this process, for calculating the concentration of sulfur dioxide or oxides of sulfur in a gas sample, we are going to use this method. That method is called as modified Western Geek method. And for calculating the oxides of sulfur or nitrogen in a air sample, for the concentration of oxides of nitrogen, we are going to use the method is called as Jacobs-Haxter method. And for the calculation of concentration of carbon monoxide in a gas sample or air sample, the method we are using is the NDIR method, because the NDIR method we are using for the purpose that carbon monoxide have the capability to absorb the infrared radiation entered in the atmosphere. Thank you.